It's been 6 months and Josie Paul still does not have an office. The chairman and the national creative director of BBDO India is busy working on the agency's sole client, Pepsico India, out of coffee shops like this one. Quite surprisingly, considering that BBDO is part of the Omnicom conglomerate, the world's largest advertising agency group. BBDO's Indian sojourn has been an interesting one. They've been in India for a while now, first in a partnership with R.K. Swami, where it was a minority partner, and now as BBDO India, again in a partnership with the Swami brothers, but this time around, it has the majority stake. The ownership pattern of both alliances was driven by regulatory requirements, but Omnicom insists it was market forces.
We already have interest in 7-Up and it's going to be a large franchise, and we'd like to focus on what we're doing right now, create the right kind of work, and BBDO India is all about the work, and once that work is right and once the talent comes into place is then when we take our next step.
The reality is that Omnicom in this market needs to challenge the status quo. We've been here, BBDO has been here a very long time. We're proud of the track record we have here, but clearly we want to make sure that we get a growing and disproportionate share of the opportunities here. So certainly from a BBDO perspective, India is incredibly important to us. It's an incredibly important market to our clients. We think that there's some great creative opportunities in this market.
Omnicom is now trying desperately playing catch-up. In the last 1 year, it has launched OMD, its media agency, with Jasmine Sorabji as its head. It has attempted to breathe back life into DDB's Indian arm, Mudra DDB, by bringing in Bobby Pawar, hoping to live up to its renowned creative credentials. Last month, it changed leadership at TBWA, hiring Shiv Sethuraman as the new CEO. BBDO India, meanwhile, has just announced a new planning director, Sangeet Pillai, from BBDO New York. The industry isn't worrying as yet, passing off Omnicom's recent moves as delayed recovery.
My view is that historically, the BBDO brand and indeed the Omnicom brands have had a strong skew to Europe and North America, and they're relative latecomers to Asia overall. That's challenging because they have no long history here. And so I think one of the things they're going to have to really figure out is how they build a critical mass in markets like India that provides them with the resources that enable them to compete. Now clearly they're focusing on that at the moment, but the dilemma you have is that I'm sure that some of the contracts that they have to deal with prescribe some of the things they'd like to do. And so it's a process. I have no doubt they're as clear as we are about what they'd like to do in India. They're just coming from a different starting point.
I don't think that we should be distracted by that. There's always been plenty of competition in every market. There's one thing that's absolutely universally true, is this is a fiercely competitive business. The fact that there's two or three or five more competitors now is something we should keep an eye on, but not get distracted by.
It may be too early for a verdict, but Omnicom have their work cut out to live up to their leader status. In a market where everyone is only as good as their billings, Omnicom, it seems, has just begun.